What is Snowflake? Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. In this video, we are going to see what is Snowflake, why Snowflake is required, how to create an account and log in into Snowflake. So let's start working on it. Before knowing exactly what is a Snowflake, you should understand that the word Snowflake has been raised by considering various scenarios and various issues that's happening in the real-time world. We all know that we have various cloud services, and most of the well-known cloud services are AWS, Azure, GCP, and so on. In the same way, Snowflake refers to a cloud-based data warehouse. Now, when I talk about the word warehouse, it means that it's a place where we store some things, where we store some resources, where we store some products. In the same way, we store some data in it. Now, when I talk about a warehouse will not be of a smaller size. It will be huge size, in such a huge size that it can store huge number of data. So the word Snowflake refers to a cloud-based data warehouse platform, which is designed in such a way that it can handle the large volumes of data, and it helps the user to analyze the data, and it is more helpful in order to do some scalability, in order to make it analyze the structured way. It is easy of use and it will support multiple workloads. Now let me walk you through a example. Let me give you a real-time example. So let us consider that we have a sales data. Now in this sales data, we have various sources like online transaction, mobile transactions, or in-store purchases. Now this particular transactions that I have talked about, they need a data warehousing platform. They need a data warehouse to handle the massive data in a real time and provide some quick insights for decision making about the sales that have happened in the business. Now, this particular sales company which I have talked about, this company wants to use Snowflake as its data warehouse. Data warehouse is nothing but they want to store the large amount of data about their business, about their sales in a Snowflake platform. Now, they started by integrating a lot of things into it. So the picture that the company is opting for Snowflake, that's where why Snowflake comes into the picture, because it is in such a position that it can handle or it can store huge amount of data, it can process the data, it can analyze the large volumes of data in real time, where someone can easily get to know the valuable insights coming out of it. So most of the organizations nowadays, they are using Snowflake as a data warehousing platform. And using this Snowflake, if you know SQL or if you know any other programming language, then Snowflake execution, writing the queries out of it, getting the result out of it, analyzing the data out of it, that will be easy using this Snowflake. So that's where Snowflake plays an important role. Now let us see how to create an account using a Snowflake. So in a Google, you need to type a Snowflake and click on get started today. The Snowflake will give you 30 days free trial version. Snowflake will give you 30 days free trial version. So after 30 days, depending upon the usage of your daily needs, depending upon the usage of the data, depending upon the usage of the size of the data that you are utilizing using a Snowflake, according to that, you need to do the payment using a credit card. Now let us enter our details here. So let me give the name M, saying you need to give the role, what you are working in an organization, and I'm from India. So we'll click on continue. Now, as soon as you click on continue, this step is a very important step. It is asking us to choose your Snowflake edition, whether you want to go with the standard edition where you need to have a strong balance between the features of the Snowflake that we have under the standard edition, or you would like to go with the enterprise level where you are getting some additional benefits when compared to standard, as you have some multi-cluster warehouses and some time travel, more time travels informations in it. Or you would like to go with the business critical, where you can enhance your security, where you can have a data protection possibility, and there are various databases fallback and lot of features that a developer or an analyst is required, that will be there under business critical. So under business critical, your standard option, your enterprise option, everything will be included under business critical. So I will choose the business critical option here. Then it is asking us to choose what kind of cloud provider you would like to opt. As I told that the cloud platforms we have, that Microsoft Azure, AWS and Google Cloud Platform, these three are the cloud services. So whichever you would like to work, or whichever your organization is asking you to work on, or whichever the project you are working and what kind of Google platform that your project is required, based upon that we can choose our right Google provider, or right, sorry, cloud provider I can talk about. So there are three things here. Either you can choose Microsoft Azure, either you can choose Amazon Web Services, or you can choose Google Cloud Platform. Out of these three, any one cloud provider, we can choose it. There's no harm in choosing only Microsoft Azure. There is no harm in choosing only AWS. There's no harm in choosing only GCP. Any cloud provider, you can choose it. That's purely depend upon your thing. Now, I would like to choose AWS because we can do lot of integrations using AWS based upon the requirements that I have. I'm going to choose AWS. If you would like to choose Azure, yes, you can choose Azure. It's purely upon you. I would like to choose AWS here. And as soon as I choose AWS, it is asking me to select my location. So by default, I have got my location, the exact location, which is Asia Pacific, which is Mumbai. Now I will check here to indicate that all the terms and conditions that I have read it. Now I'll click on get started. As soon as I click on get started, now thanks for signing up with Snowflake. It is asking you a few questions, that why are you signing up for a trial, whether it is for a company is considering Snowflake, or you would go for a training or certification using Snowflake, or some other information. So if you would like to give this particular answer, you can give it. If you don't want, you can skip it. As simple as such. So in the same way, what will you use Snowflake for? Again, there are some questions. If you would like to answer these questions, happily we can answer these questions. If you do not want it, we can skip it up. So I'll skip this question as well. And select your preferred language to work. As I told in the introduction, that using a Snowflake, we can write the queries using SQL or any other programming language, but SQL is the most feasible and most easy way of writing the queries in Snowflake. So SQL will be, it works a lot in SQL if you use it. If you don't want SQL, if you would like to choose any other programming language, we can choose it. If you do not want this question as well, we can skip this question. As soon as we skip it, you are now signed up. As you can see that it is telling me you are now signed up. An email has been sent to my email for verification. So as soon as I open up my email and click on this email, I have got one email link where I need to activate it. As soon as I click to activate, my particular Snowflake account has been successfully created and activated. So now you need to give your username and password. Whichever username and password you give, it purely upon your choice. Let me give the same thing called as M. Hussein, the name that I have given. I'll give my password. As soon as I give my password, okay, you need to click on get started. Once we click on this get started, my Snowflake account is successfully created. I can use this Snowflake account for 30 days. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.